Night. Expose number one, drugs angle would have been buried completely. Pithani flip-flops would never have surfaced. Ria's lies wouldn't have been exposed. Mumbai police's February inaction of the family's complaint would have gone unnoticed. India would never have known about the SSR diary damage that happened before it reached the forensics. Fans would never have known about the Hollywood Dreams note that was written by Sushant Singh Rajput. SSR's financial record would have remained suppressed forever. Ria's breakup chat with Mahesh Bhatt would have gone completely unnoticed on the 8th of June, crucial date when she left the house of Sushant Singh Rajput, a man she was supposed to be in love with. Mumbai police's mystery calls wouldn't have come to light at all. B-Town's drug mafia would have continued to thrive in the manner that they always have. So, ladies and gentlemen, the legitimate question on the news hour tonight is just one. Have B-Town proxies blocking the justice for Sushant? That's the big question and the debate on the other side. Can't block SSR justice.
You're watching the news hour. Coming. Debate number two on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Lawyer Vikas Gupta and Priyanka Deol now join the panel. And I want to ask you, Tehsin Poonawalla, are you in favor of this gag that wants ex-cops? And these are no mean cops. These are all top cops of Mumbai who have gotten together almost as if it is a union of police commissioners who are now questioning the rights of the media in a land where freedom of expression and freedom of speech is being hauled as the most liberal values of the Constitution. You want the media gagged now on this? Why, sir?
The writer of the Constitution, Sri Babasaheb Ambedkar, Maharashtra was his karmabhumi, but this is also the janmabhumi of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. We respect everybody, but we are not going to take repeated insults from the BJP or their supporters about our Mumbai police. Sadhvi Pragya had insulted my friend, my personal friend, Hemant Karkare, who is a martyr. And I'm going to be very brief and I'm going to end what I'm saying. There has been a lot of filth and a lot of lies spoken about the Mumbai police. Vikas sir is here. Vikas sir also said that the Marathi thing was not read out to them. As per the rule, they have to be read out and had to be interpreted. That rule was done. But a lot of things have been said, which has been one-sided, targeting my Mumbai police. I am standing by it. You say what you want about the government, no problem. Do not insult our Mumbai police. This is our...
Why, sir? Why, sir? Dr. Anand Ranganathan, may I tell you the lapses that we have pointed out in Times Now? The lapses of the crime scene sanctity being destroyed? The lapses that showed that the Mumbai police, in 45 minutes of the dead body being discovered, said it is a suicide, case closed, file over. The fact that 57 witnesses or people were questioned without even registering an FIR for 75-80 days. Why? Why should we not question the fact that mystery people were going in, picking up bags, walking out of Sushant Singh Rajput's room at a time when there should have been an investigation? Should we not ask the question that why did the Mumbai police not hand over the phone of Sushant Singh Rajput for forensic analysis for 24 days? Why should we not ask the question that the post-mortem report, which was recommended by the Mumbai police, had no time of death on it, and the Mumbai police never thought it was important to raise that question? Why should we not ask these questions, Mr. Dr. Anand Ranganathan? Do you think anybody can stop me from asking these questions about the lapses of the Mumbai police? I will ask them today and every single day till justice is delivered to Sushant Singh Rajput. Am I wrong to raise these questions, Dr. Anand Ranganathan?
Why is CBI not arrested? You believe in the witchcraft theory? Your correspondent said that they were investigating witchcraft.
No, calm down, Tehsin Poonawalla. Look, I was silent.
Calm down, Tehsin Poonawalla. I heard you the first time. You can't go on speaking.
I'm not going on speaking.
Dr. Anand Ranganathan, please lower the fader of Tehsin.
Yeah, Navika, there are two issues here and I beg 2 minutes of your indulgence because both are very important. You see, media trial is being used as an excuse either by the accused or the government to prevent legitimate investigation by journalists or by vested interests within the media that don't want the story chased because it goes against their narrative or ideology, or quite simply, they themselves aren't chasing it. On the first, It is amply clear, you have said so yourself right now, that the Mumbai police has committed more errors than a viral reverse transcriptase without a proofreading function. I bet you. Had it not been for the media, we wouldn't have known the accused was allowed unregistered inside the morgue, that the time of death was left blank on the autopsy report, that electronic records weren't confiscated, that the financial and the drugs angles weren't investigated. And as for the second issue, where other journalists are crying media trial, these are the very shameless cretins that have conducted media trials for decades, including making digital bathtubs to reconstruct victims' drowning. Even now, the channel preaching morality till the other day soon dispatched reporters to the school of the accused. It broadcast sugar candy interview that criminally breached patient-doctor confidentiality and slandered the victim and his family. It pounded the doors of shirtless folks. Then it is not media trial. When you carry out sickening blanket coverage in the Loya case to coerce the judge, hound the family, slander the Supreme Court, then it is not media trial. When you run around town beating your chest and pen column yards to save terrorists on death row to mold judicial opinion, then it is not media trial. Even today, these Muppets, including Tehsin possibly, call the Bofors investigation a media trial. Look, we live in a democracy. Anyone can approach the courts if he feels he's the victim of a media trial. Please give me 30 seconds. Other than that, media can and does have a vital role. Even the courts have praised it. Had it not been for the media, the killer of Jessica would never have been caught. Remember, we don't have a jury system, so there's no question of a mistrial or not being able to fight jurors. So ignore these Janus-faced journals, Navika. Theirs are wails of a baby without a rattler or a soother. They used to suck blood, now it's just thumbs.
Well, I want to ask Vikas Gupta, who's also a lawyer, Upahar tragedy, Nitish Katara case, Nirbhaya gang rape, where a law was changed, Aditya Sachdeva, MLC's son, Unnao rape case, Jessica Lal murder case, Keenan Reuben murders, Tuticorin custodial deaths, Mumbai hit and run cases, innumerable cases where media has had a role to play to keep the pressure up and demand transparency and accountability in investigations. I want to ask you, why is the Mumbai police above every other constitutional right? Why should they not be absolutely accountable to the people of this country? Why should taxpayers who pay for the cost of running that police establishment not have a transparent Mumbai police reporting to them and proving to them that they are accountable and carrying out an unbiased investigation? Why, sir?
Navika, I'm for one never in favor of gagging the media. I personally not only feel, but I also firmly believe in the fact that media is the fourth pillar of democracy. But here in this case, with little reservation, I want to make a point that you can't go on bashing Ria. I think media also needs to be.
But the case is not about Ria, sir. The case is about Mumbai police. The case is not about Ria. And Ria can call Sushant Singh Rajput Gaurav Bhatia. Ria can call Sushant Singh Rajput bipolar. She can call him mentally unstable. She can call him that he was depressed from 2013. His mother died because of depression. All that can be said.
Navika, please allow
Navika,
me.
Navika, your
me.
Channel, you,
please,
Rahul Shivshankar, have sinned. You should have said that Ria G is a very dedicated partner. Sushant Singh Rajput wasn't a big star. Sushant Singh Rajput was on drugs. You should have applauded the exemplary conduct of the Mumbai police for not registering an FIR for 65 days. You should have also told every citizen that penguins fly.
Wow.
And they fly with drug peddlers.
You tell me,
and you should have told the audience
if a suicide has been committed under which
sugar and salt being consumed, it is not okay. And that is why you are saying now.
Priyanka, I'm sorry I'm running out of time. But this is an important issue. And as a citizen of this country, Priyanka, I want to ask you. Priyanka, if the media had not kept the pressure up, would we have seen the case traveling even this far?
Absolutely not, Navika. And, you know, trying to put a gag on media and democracy are two things that just don't go together. Now, Mr. Poonawalla made a point a little bit before. I'm from Mumbai as well, but I don't feel, he said that, you know, don't insult our Mumbai police, but I don't feel it's my police. And Navika, you, because of your coverage yesterday or day before, you had a drug dealer come up and say, bade log hai, bada risk hai, mera life ko. So this is what makes people alert. Isn't everyone equal under the law? this shows that Mumbai police are either lackluster or it shows that they have loopholes, and it definitely that they are tied to all of these big people.
That's the point. I'm sorry I'm cutting you short, Priyanka, but the question really is, it's not Mumbai police as a monolith. Clearly, one bad fish spoils the whole pond. We don't know whether there are one, two, or five or ten bad fish. But the fact is that there are bad fish in the Mumbai police who didn't do their job the way it was supposed to have been done. In such a case, who can take away our right to report what's right? Has there been any question raised about the facts we've put out? Where were these chats on drugs? If the Mumbai police never took them out, did they want them buried? Did they not want the media to have their hands on these kind of drug chats, which would have shown complicity of the Mumbai police? That's the question I want to ask the Mumbai police and everybody who's petitioning the courts now to gag us. We will bring facts, more facts. The more you press us down, the more you want to gag us, we will bring out more facts. Because as the Fourth Estate, we never back off.